Welcome back, you lovely weirdos. It's your number one fan Asian coming to you again with another one of these intriguing FIFA 18 experiments. And today, we're gonna be looking into the troubled past of one Jose Mourinho. Well, he recently pulled off one of the greatest comebacks of the season at the Etihad, and he's also defeated the rock star antics of Liverpool. Jose Mourinho has, let's just call it a checkered past when it comes to letting talent go a little bit prematurely. So I thought to myself, what would it look like if you created a team full of Jose Mourinho rejects and put him up against his current team in Manchester United right now? Who would finish on top? And that goes ahead and gets your nipples hard. Smush your hard wreck nipple into that like button right now. Subscribe for more oddball FIFA 18 content. And today we will go ahead, and if I get my prediction wrong, we'll be giving away either $20 worth in FIFA points or $20 worth in V-Bucks, your choice. But first, let's go ahead. Let's meet the teams and let's meet the more interesting one. Let's see the rejects. Now, to qualify as a Jose Mourinho reject, essentially at one point or another, you had to have either been sold or loaned out by Jose Mourinho. There's a lot of familiar faces on here, although I did make one exception onto this list. As you can see right here, Mesut Ozil technically was not sold while Jose Mourinho was still at Real Madrid, but the previous season he did kind of freeze him out, and there were a lot of rumors that there was a falling out between the two and they were going to move on from Ozil. Jose Mourinho was fired pretty much at the end of that season, and then the subsequently following summer, just a couple months later, Ozil was sold onto Arsenal. So I'm putting him on this team just because I wanted it a little bit stronger. Now, probably the most famous two who have been making huge waves this season in the Premier League, of course, is Mohamed Salah, who since returned to the Premier League has been lights out. You could argue maybe he's the player of the year now. And then the other guy who's competing up there with player for year in the Premier League is one Kevin De Bruyne. Had for a short time over at Chelsea, loaned him out, and then from that point, I think he sold him over to Wolfsburg, and the rest is history. Now, there are actually a couple of high-profile rejects that Jose Mourinho has reacquired on his current Manchester United team. That being, of course, Juan Mata, who he famously sold to Manchester United, and then Romelu Lukaku, who he had over at Chelsea, and then I think he, like, moved him on. He loaned him out a couple of times before eventually selling him on to Everton. I've decided that since they're on the current Manchester United roster, I'm going to leave them there. But have no fear, this team of rejects is still pretty strong without them. As you can see up top, you got Zlatan Ibrahimovic. He was sold over to Barcelona when Jose Mourinho was the manager over at Inter. The backup strikers for him, of course, is Daniel Sturridge. He was sold over to Liverpool from Chelsea. Samuel Eto'o. Iron Robin was sold to Real Madrid during his first stint over at Chelsea. If we're going to go with the true left wing, then Memphis Depay is going to be in there. Sold from Manchester United to Lyon. Scored a couple of pretty nice goals for Lyon since leaving. Charisma, I believe he sold during his time over at, oh my god, I do not know which one. It was either like Inter or the first time he was over at Chelsea. Schürrle was kind of like a one and done over at Chelsea. And then Nathan was another one of those Chelsea youth products that is just constantly loaned out. On the right side, doesn't get much better. Besides Mohamed Salah, there's Juan Cuadrado, who is now over at Juventus. Henry Mkhitaryan was sold just this past January. Anand Yanaze was sold in the previous summer. And then there's Bertrand Traoré, who I believe is also over at Lyon. Now, midfield was kind of a weak position. It seems like Jose knows his midfielders pretty well, because the ones that he's moved on from, I would say hasn't been too bad besides the likes of Kevin De Bruyne. You got Sebastian Schweinsteiger, but I mean, he was at the end of his career. Schneiderlin, he never really cut it at Man United and hasn't done all too well since. Wayne Rooney, he was at the end of his career as well. So, I mean, no real big misses besides Kevin De Bruyne. Kevin De Bruyne is a pretty big miss, though. The left-back position, they had Felipe Luis was over at Chelsea for like 1 year, and then he was done. Behind him, you have the likes of Patrick Van Aanholt, as well as Ryan Bertrand, who's over at Southampton now. I think both of them were over at Chelsea and then were eventually sold on. Bonucci was on his side at Inter before he was like sold on to some like random League 2, like Italian side before he went on to AC Milan. David Luiz was famously sold, then brought back for a second stint over at Chelsea. That was pretty interesting. He's also had the likes of Garay, who I'm not totally sure what team he had him in. It was either at Real Madrid or Inter. Christensen was one of the kids who's constantly loaned out over at Chelsea. Same thing with Nathaniel Aki. I think Huth was also at Chelsea during his like first stint or something before being sold on. I could be mistaken. Victor Moses is another guy who was constantly loaned in and out. And then in the keeper position, you got Petr Cech, who was sold on to Arsenal once they found a successor in Thibaut Courtois. I don't think they're stressing all too much. Pretty tough to find a backup keeper in actuality. There was like Schwarzer, who was over at Leicester for a little while, but then he's not in the game anymore. And there was Victor Valdez, who we sold when he was at Manchester United. He retired. So the best guy that I have in here backing up Cech is this man, Jamal Blackman. So as you can see, it is a treasure trove of talent. And I mean, there could be players in here that still yet could come back to bite his ass. Like Mkhitaryan, Cuadrado, they're still relatively young. They could kick it up another gear. Same thing with, you know, Ryan Bertrand, Nathaniel Aki could be a world beater. Technically, Christensen was phenomenal for the first half of this season. Memphis Depay is another guy who's got, you know, a really high ceiling. We just haven't seen the best come out of him. I mean, you could be looking at a couple of these faces that are, you know, tomorrow's Kevin De Bruyne or Mohamed Salah. I don't think there's another manager who has whiffed on so much talent during his career. But is it better than his current Manchester United team? This is a side that he set up against Manchester City over the weekend. You got Romelu Lukaku up top, former reject. You got Paul Pogba, who's actually technically a Sir Alex Ferguson reject. You got Jesse Lingard out on the right side. You got Sanchez over on the left with Ashley Young. By Smalling and Valencia in the back line with a midfield of Herrera and Matic and David De Gea, best keeper in the world right now, in between the sticks. You have another former reject in Wamata, Rashford, Martial, Rojo, and then you guys basically know the rest of the characters in here. So this is the gauntlet that has been thrown down. We're going to go ahead and get ourselves into the Premier League. I am not going to be simming as either one of these teams. As you can see right here, we sit on July 1st of 2017. I'm going to be simming as Everton as to remain neutral. You guys can go ahead, vote up in the eye thingies right now. Which team do you think will reign supreme? Now, they don't necessarily have to go ahead and win the league. It's just whoever ends up on top of the table. As for me, I have to go ahead and make a prediction. If I get it right, nothing bad happens to me. I just sit here all nice and pleasant. But if something bad happens, then I have to do a forfeit. And as I mentioned before, we're gonna be giving away $20 worth of FIFA points or $20 worth of V-Bucks for all you kids playing Fortnite. If I'm just gonna basic football knowledge, the starting line is the Regis. Ridiculous. The better team, I could argue that they're bench than the Manchester United team is. Old veteran of the United. And it's very, very difficult to beat them in any type of simulation, no matter what players that they have on them. So I'm gonna go with the current Manchester United roster. I know that it's hard to say, but if you look at real life, he beat Mohamed Salah and he beat Kevin De Bruyne over the past 2 weeks. So is it that far-fetched? We will have to see, but let's go ahead. We're gonna sim it up to the halfway point right here into January and see how it goes. Take it away, Time Wizard. Go Time Wizard! All right, we sit on January 1st of 2018. Let's see how the rejects slash current team are doing. Player stats. Hazard is on Liverpool. I didn't change that. He's just on Liverpool. All right, interesting. Although I did move, oh, that's probably why. I think I moved Eden Hazard onto a different team since I'm using Chelsea for the rejects and it wasn't a very strong team. So I'm pretty sure Liverpool bought him. And Leicester City bought Mandzukic and Manchester United brought Vardy. This is a very, very strange simulation. I'm not gonna lie. And there's no one on here from Chelsea. It's all the way down here is Quaresma and Ibrahimovic in 17th and 16th place. All right. And Arsenal bought Asensio? What is going on in this career mode? Tottenham bought Quincy Promise? What the hell? I didn't do this. They all bought it on their own. Okay, I'm going to keep on going. All right, David Silva is on top right here. Sigurdsson is in second place. No one until Jesse Lingard in eighth place for Manchester United. And then not too far underneath him is Iron Robin in 10th place.
And there's also Andre Schurrle, who's in 14th place. Let's go over to clean sheets. Simon Mignolet is on top of the league. Interesting, I guess. Pieter Cech is in 9th place. And oh dear, oh dear, oh dear. David De Gea is nowhere to be seen. Although Pereira also has 2 clean sheets, so technically they have 4, which is more than Pieter Cech. So, okay, I'm feeling okay right here. Let's check out where they sit in the table. It is Spurs on top. Chelsea is in 3rd place. Oh, God. Chelsea is in 3rd. Manchester United is all the way in 7th. This is base Manchester United. They're 10 points off of Chelsea. What the fuck is going on? I don't really have words to say. I can't really describe what is going on. There's been some absolute banana transfers that have... that have thrown a monkey wrench in my prediction. But, you know, let's just carry on. We're just into the end of the season and see if Manchester United can make up 10 points. I think I lost this one. Go Time Wizard! All right, we sit on June 1st, 2018. You might have noticed something is different. I'm simming as Brighton right now. You know why? Because I got fired as Everton. Anyway, it doesn't really affect anything here. Let's go over player stats. See how it ended. It is Leroy Sané who finishes with the golden boot on top. Liverpool, Eden Hazard, finishes in 2nd place, with Roberto Firmino finishing in 3rd. We go all the way down to Zlatan Ibrahimovic, who is the first of the rejects to go ahead and show up. He has, 13 goals. But Manchester United's Jamie Vardy is also tied with him with 13 goals as well. Let's go over to assist. Sigurdsson finishes on top, but if we take a look at either the rejects, all right, Mohamed Salah is in 8th place, and there's a lot of Chelsea players on here. Memphis Depay also has 6, while Arjen Robben has 5. There are no Manchester United players on here. Clean sheets, Petr Cech finishes in 2nd place with 10 clean sheets, and then David De Gea, not too far behind with 9. Still, you've got to give the edge to Chelsea and the rejects right here. I'm pretty sure they had 10 points that they had to make up. Let's go ahead. Let's take a look at the top of the table. Chelsea win the league. So not only did they best Manchester United, they went on a bunch of Jose Mourinho rejects, went on to go ahead and win the league. By one point, it wasn't huge. They had the tied for the best goal differential with Manchester United. And it was actually a very, very close race. The top 5 were only separated by 5 points. I just cannot get a prediction right recently. I mean, like 99% of the time, they skew toward Manchester United heavily. And this is probably the worst performance I've ever seen from a Manchester United simming in any of these experiments. But hey, you the viewer, yes, you right there, you get to reap the rewards. If you want to be qualified to win either $20 worth of FIFA points or $20 worth of V-Bucks, follow me at BMOnus. Like this video, of course, leave a comment down below, and then tweet me a picture of your favorite Jose Mourinho reject. I'm going to give you guys, let's say, 1 week from when this video comes out, and then I'll be choosing one of you winners at total random. But yeah, that's pretty much it for me. If you want to check out some more oddball FIFA content, I do career mode where Donald Trump takes over a goddamn team and tries to ruin everything in England. That one's a fun one. If you want to check out my latest FIFA 18 experiment, there's another nice spicy little reward in that one. Go ahead and click up here, Dings Boost. But until next time, guys, it's your boy, BMOnus. Hopefully you guys are having a wonderful day. Remember, stay yourself, stay humble, and remember, stay chubby.